In this illustration, we'll discuss about the force required to slide a block under another block. Here the figure shows a block B placed on another block A. Here B is attached to wall by a string PQ as we can see, and it is saying if the friction coefficient between the two blocks and ground is 0.25, we are required to find the minimum horizontal force F required to slide the block A. Now, in this situation, to understand the situation better, we need to analyze all forces acting in the system. Here we can see in this diagram, we'll first analyze the forces. Like due to this force, first a tension T is developed over here. A normal reaction is acting between block A and ground, say this is N1. Another normal reaction is between block A and B, say this normal reaction is N2. When force is applied on A and it is pulled, friction will oppose the motion of block A. So on both the surfaces, friction will act in opposite direction. This will be mu N1 and this will be mu N2. And according to Newton's third law, block B will experience a reaction of this friction, which is mu N2 toward left, which is the cause of tension in this string. So if we draw the free body diagram of these two blocks and analyze the situation, we can see free body diagram of block A. Here we can see it will experience its weight as A is of 20 kg mass. It will be 20 g in downward direction and a normal reaction N1 upward. Toward left, it will experience the external force, and toward right, the two frictions, mu times N1 plus N2 is acting on it. And if we draw the free body diagram of block B, here we can see it will experience its weight in downward direction, that is 10 g, a normal reaction upward, which is N2, and from horizontal at an angle 45 degree, the tension in a string is acting onto it. The friction mu N2 will be acting on it toward left. Now here, for limiting equilibrium, or just the condition of for just starting the sliding of block A, here we can balance the forces, and for block B first we can see here mu N2 should be equal to T cos 45, that is T by root 2. And in normal direction we can write N2 plus T by root 2 is equal to its weight, that is 100 Newton. So we substitute the value of T by root 2 and substitute the value of mu as 0.25. This will be N2 1.25 is equal to 100. And this will result the value of normal reaction acting on block B due to A, which is 100 by 1.25, this is 80 Newton. And here if we calculate the value of N1, here we can see this will be 20 g plus one more normal reaction due to B is acting on A. So here we take this N2 plus N2, and the value of N2, we know it is 80 Newton, so this will be 280 Newton as we are taking the value of G at 10. Now in this situation, if we know N1 and N2, we can calculate the minimum force required to slide the block A, which is mu times N1 plus N2, which is here 0.25 multiplied by here N1 is 280 plus N2 is 80. That is 0.25 multiplied by 360, which will give us 90 Newton. So this will be the result of this problem, the minimum force required to start sliding in block A.